What are we made of? Are you just a body or are you just a mind? Or are you both of them or are you neither of them? Are we real or are we just an illusion or the dreams of the gods? How can you know for sure that you are real? René Descartes connected the reality of existence to thought by saying, "I think, therefore I am," which implies that thought exists and it gives proof to the existence of matter. But this phrase is also conversely understood by saying, "I am, therefore I think," giving preference to tangibility and existence of matter, which then ultimately evolves into a thought. These paradoxical philosophies about existence have been propounded, studied, invented, and followed for millennia in Hindu philosophy. Hindu philosophy encompasses the philosophies, worldviews, and teachings that emerged in ancient India. In Indian tradition, the word used for philosophy is darshana. This word comes from the Sanskrit root drish, which means to see or experience. Since ancient times, Indian philosophy has been categorized into Astik and Nastik schools of thought. The orthodox or the Astik schools of Hindu philosophy have been called Shadadarshana or six systems.
In Astika systems, each darshana accepts the Vedas as the authority. Each Astik darshan also accepts the premise that Atma, the soul or the eternal self, exists and has a certain epistemology. Epistemology is called Pramana. It is a Hindu theory of knowledge and discusses the valid means by which human beings can gain accurate knowledge. The first one among the Astika school of philosophy is Sankhya. Sankhya is the oldest of the Astika philosophical systems in Hinduism, with origins in the first millennium BCE. It is a rather rationalist school of Indian philosophy and had a strong influence on other schools of Indian philosophy. Sankhya's epistemology accepted three of the six pramanas as the only reliable means of gaining knowledge. These were pratyaksha, which is perception, anumana, that is inference, and shabda, that is testimony. Sankhya school espouses dualism between consciousness and matter. It regards the universe as consisting of two realities, Purusha, which is consciousness, and Prakriti, that is matter. Jiva, or a living being, is that state in which Purusha is bonded to Prakriti in some form. This fusion led to the emergence of Buddhi, or awareness and intellect, and Ahankara, that is individualized ego, or consciousness, or the I-maker. The universe is described by this school as the one created by Purusha Prakriti entities infused with various permutations and combinations of variously enumerated elements, senses, feelings, activity, and mind. Samkhya philosophy includes a theory of guna, that is qualities or innate tendencies or the human psyche. Guna, it states, are of three types, sattva, rajas, and tamas. As per Samkhya, everything, all life forms and human beings have these three gunas, but in different proportions. The interplay of these gunas defines the character of someone or something of nature and determines the progress of life.
The second school of Astik philosophy is Yoga. In Indian philosophy, Yoga is the name of one of the six Astik philosophical schools. It aligns closely with the dualist premises of the Sankhya school. Yoga accepts the concept of personal God, that is Ishvara, unlike Sankhya. The epistemology of the Yoga school also relies on three of six pramanas as the means of gaining reliable knowledge. Pratyaksha, that is perception, anumana, that is inference, and shabda, that is testimony of reliable sources. The universe is conceptualized as a duality in Yoga school: Purusha, that is consciousness, and Prakriti, that is matter. However, the Yoga school discusses this concept more generically as seer and seen, or experiencer and the experienced, than the Sankhya school. The Yoga school builds on the Sankhya school theory that jnana, that is knowledge, is a sufficient means to moksha. it suggests that systematic techniques or practice, that is personal experimentation, combined with Sankhya's approach to knowledge is the path to moksha.
The third one is the Vaisheshika philosophy, which is a naturalist school. It is a form of atomism in natural philosophy. It postulates that all objects in the physical universe are reducible to Paramanu or the atoms, and that one's experiences are derived from the interplay of substance, that is a function of atoms, their number and their spatial arrangements. Apart from this, they are also dependent on quality, activity, commonness, particularity and inherence. Knowledge and liberation are achievable by complete understanding of the world of experience according to the Vaisheshika school of philosophy. Vaisheshika metaphysical premises are found on the form of atomism, that reality is composed of four substances: earth, water, air and fire. Each of these four is of two types: atomic, that is Paramanu, and composite. An atom is that which is indestructible or anitya, indivisible, and has a special kind of dimension called small or anu. The Vaisheshika philosophy states that size, form, truths and everything that human beings experience as a whole is a function of atoms, their number and their spatial arrangements, as well as their guna, which is quality, karma, that is activity, samanya, that is commonness, vishesha, that is particularity, and amavaya, that is inherence.
The fourth school of philosophy is the Nyaya school, which is a realist astic philosophy. The school's most significant contributions to Indian philosophy were its systematic development of the theory of logic, methodology, and its treatises on epistemology. Nyaya epistemology accepts 4 out of 6 pramanas as reliable means of gaining knowledge: pratyaksha, that is perception, anumana, that is inference, upamana, that is comparison and analogy, and shabda, that is testimony. It holds that human suffering results from mistakes or defects produced by activity under wrong knowledge or ignorance. Moksha is gained through right knowledge. Correct knowledge is discovering and overcoming one's delusions and understanding the true nature of the soul, self and reality.
The fifth school of Astika philosophy is Mimamsa school, that emphasized on the critical interpretation of a text. It is a form of philosophical realism. The Mimamsa school has several sub-schools defined by epistemology. The Prabhakara sub-school of Mimamsa accepted 5 means to gaining knowledge as epistemologically reliable. The first one is pratyaksha, that is perception. The second is anumana or inference. The third is upamana or comparison and analogy. The fourth is arthapatti, that is postulation, derivation from circumstances, etc. And shabda, which is testimony. The Kumarila Bhatta sub-school of Mimamsa added a sixth way of knowing called as anupalabdhi, that is negative or cognitive proof. It holds that the soul is an eternal, omnipresent, inherently active spiritual essence that focused on epistemology and metaphysics of dharma. The Mimamsakas held the Vedas are eternally authorless, infallible, that Vedic vidhi or the injunctions and mantras in rituals are prescriptive karya or the actions, and that the rituals are of primary importance and merit. They considered the Upanishads and the other texts related to self-knowledge and spirituality to be of secondary importance. Mimamsa school gave rise to the study of philology and the philosophy of language. The Mimamsakas considered the purpose and power of language was to clearly prescribe the proper, the correct, and the right.
The sixth school, that is, the Vedanta school, is built upon the teachings of the Upanishads and Brahma Sutras from the first millennium BCE and is the most developed and best known of the Hindu schools. The epistemology of the Vedantins included, depending on the sub-school, 5 or 6 methods as proper and reliable means of gaining any form of knowledge: pratyaksha, that is perception, anumana, that is inference, upamana, that is comparison and analogy, arthapatti, that is postulation, anupalabdhi, that is non-perception, negative or cognitive proof, and shabda, that is testimony. All of these have been further categorized by each sub-school of Vedanta in terms of conditionality, completeness, confidence, and possibility of error. The emergence of Vedanta school represented a period when a more knowledge-centered understanding began to emerge. These focused on jnana, that is knowledge-driven aspects of the Vedic religion and the Upanishads. This included metaphysical concepts such as Atman and Brahman, and an emphasis on meditation, self-discipline, self-knowledge, and abstract spirituality, rather than ritualism. The Upanishads were variously interpreted by ancient and medieval era Vedanta scholars. Consequently, the Vedanta separated into many sub-schools ranging from theistic dualism to non-theistic monism, each interpreting the texts in its own way and producing its own series of sub-commentaries. Thus, the six schools of philosophy represented ideologies that cover the physical, the delusional, and to the metaphysical. These schools are not just the reflection of what lies outside yourself, but also about how it connects to everything inside of us. It gives you an idea about subjectively knowing the Creator from the spirit while simultaneously inculcating an attitude of being realistic and factual. Hindu philosophy is perhaps the only philosophy in the entire world which accommodates all types of ideas, let it be religious, Sikh religious, theistic or atheistic. This free-thinking intellectual culture was philosophically light years ahead of its time. So follow our page Satyalok on Instagram as we bring to you the exploration of each of these Astika as well as Nastika schools of philosophy. Stay tuned, and last but not the least, know your culture from a philosophical perspective. Shubhasthya Panthana Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you.